We were watching a movie, and then I came back downstairs to load some stuff up, and I decided, Pulp Fiction just loaded up. Let me pop that on. So I pop it on. I don't even think I made it through the first scene. I was just out. I woke up to... And they're walking out of the diner. Yeah. It's like, all right. They're tucking the guns down their pants, walking out of the diner. Credits roll. Dude, I slept through Pulp Fiction in a movie theater with the sound like on 8.
I couldn't sleep last night. And, Don't ask me why I own it, but I put in Norbit, the DVD.
All right. Well,
I couldn't sleep for so long. It started over again, and I was like, "Did I really just lay here through a lap and a half of Norbit, just trying to get to sleep?" And I couldn't.
Norbit.
I just kept rolling over and seeing Eddie Murphy as a different, in a different foam rubber
Eddie
suit.
Eddie Murphy. It's starring Eddie Murphy.
I bought it at Blockbuster for like $5.
You got robbed.
Because I thought, I was like, how? I just thought, it's got to be kind of funny.
No, it isn't.
You're pretty right
there
on that.
There is just nothing. Eddie Murphy stopped making funny movies. He stopped. Me and Danny were just talking about that. It was like, I think Coming to America, that was like his last funny movie.
He's still funny, though.
He is.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Some of his movies
but what's
may not,
he doing?
But he's still funny, man.
What's he doing, though?
He got caught up in family. For some reason, family's money, he went from adult when he was a kid to doing raunchy adult things. So
right.
As an adult, he's doing things like Nash Bridges. What's that? Pluto Nash.
And
Beverly Hills Cop 3. And what's the one?
Dr. Doolittle.
What Rock is messing up doing. The Rock is doing the same thing.
Family stuff.
Too much goofy. Rock should be some type of big time villain, man.
What happened to Vin Diesel when he made that stupid movie
the duck? Yes.
What was the duck movie? I loved Vin until then.
Oof. Yeah, I know.
Pitch Black was great.
How dare you say that's what happened to him?
Pitch Black was a great movie, man.
And the Chronicles of Riddick.
That was a good one, too.
This kind of hardcore dude.
Right.
Dark, as they go, heavy, as they go, which is what... Little Kim face. What's the guy that got a comeback? He's made a comeback. Mickey Rourke.
Mickey Rourke.
Yeah.
Little Kim face.
his only thing is going to be, he should just play just heavies, man.
Yeah.
That's it.
And he can't even play like Vin Diesel trying to be the good guy hero thing doesn't work. Like, you know, in Triple X.
That's what's going on with Eddie Murphy. That's what's going on with Eddie Murphy is that he got caught up into family friendly, which is where all the money is, I guess. But
when you see people like Ice Cube doing that crappy,
oh Jesus,
what was he doing that movie where his whole family?
Are you there yet? And are you done yet? Are you home yet? Are you there yet?
When they show like him falling backwards off a ladder as he's trying to fix the roof,
yeah, that's good.
Shut up.
I think back to when I was 12 when I was. I was such a big rap fan, and Ice Cube scared me.
He was hardcore.
I was afraid of him. I was afraid of him because he just seemed like the realest dude ever.
Yeah.
And now he's driving minivans around.
Yeah.
Or teaching kids to play football. If one more hard, tough guy is teaching kids to play football in a movie,
I swear to God. That's the thing. No one has. So I guess we won't understand what
screw
the mentality.
Understanding. There's
I don't know.
Something that
I mean,
goes with like your I don't know.
Clint Eastwood has kids.
Say that again?
Yeah. Clint Eastwood has kids.
He still's making.
Yeah, but also Clint Eastwood can do anything he wants. So if you can do anything you want, I mean, Eddie could do anything he wants, but not really. Clint Eastwood is a guy that can do anything he wants to do. Eddie Murphy still he's still at, like, the only dude that can do anything he wants now is Will Smith. Like, he's the only person I know that can do anything he wants in a movie. Where he can play good guy, bad guy, dead, dark.
But I don't,
And
do you think he could? Do you think he could really go out on a limb? I mean, I think he's got a box office responsibility to fulfill here. I don't think he could go and turn around and start doing.
Well, he made sugar. What is this thing? Chocolate? What is this last thing?
7 pounds.
7 pounds. That was like
sugar
a
chocolate.
Whatever. I don't know.
What the hell is sugar chocolate?
I didn't want to see it. It might as well be called sugar chocolate.
That true diabetic would say that. The movie is called 7 pounds. How much sugar and chocolate would I like?
I just hadn't. There's nothing in me to see that movie.
But did it bomb? It was a bomb, wasn't it?
Because it was a nothing movie.
What was it about? I kept seeing posters for it. I never even saw a trailer.
Some guy feels guilty about something, gives up his organs.
Will Smith
is the end.
Will Smith is bigger than the. See, he's at the point where Tom Cruise
bigger.
Was. He's bigger than the movie's name.
Yeah,
he's just like. It's like Will Smith, and then the movie. The movie is it doesn't even matter.
But, he could sell a movie, but Eddie Murphy was at that point in his career years ago, and he somehow
I would say it was over at Beverly Hills Cop 3 was when that was a wrap.
Well, because he made Beverly Hills Cop 3. The guy should have,
No, but he made Nutty Professor after that. Nutty Professor was all right, man.
Big hit. It was good, but he
that
went
was
the
right.
wrong direction. I think what happened is, I think Boomerang...
Oh.
Should have been the way he went. He was becoming an older, smoother dude. There was younger, Martin Lawrence was coming up, and David Alan Grier was coming up. There was younger, hungrier, funny guys.
Mm-hmm.
He was more of a older, smooth, funny, and he should have went into that place where he was just
tried
like a Billy D. Williams.
Right,
Boomerang wasn't a failure. It was a failure. See, Boomerang, Eddie Murphy should be having... what Tyler Perry has. Tyler Perry is winning, but it's not blockbuster 200 million, it's blockbuster just the black people. that's a blockbuster to just have one group love you enough to make you the box office.
Tyler Perry's movies stink.
I can't
so
believe.
Bad.
I mean,
they stink. Bobby Kelly's the funniest thing because we were talking about Eddie Murphy, and he goes, "Tyler Perry is trying to be Eddie Murphy." He goes, "He's not even trying. He just puts that wig on. He doesn't even attempt to look like a woman."
But that's where Eddie Murphy should have went. Eddie Murphy should have went strictly black, but he had to go family. When we chase white dollars too, if you make $1 million, that's a lot of money, but people try to chase a guillion white dollars. Like, it's just...
But why does... I think it's great that Tyler Perry is catering to what you're saying he's catering to, but why do the movies have to stink so bad? They stink, dude. They're bad movies, Patrice. No, I'm asking.
No, you're not. Don't flip up. You was talking to convince me.
No.
I didn't argue with you.
I'm saying why...
I'm not a fan of Madea's this and...
They're fucking terrible.
And House of Pain. I'm not fans of that.
Sorry.
She is... Goddamn
it. Yeah, I'm not into that. I'm just not into that.
They're terrible.
Eddie Murphy, lifetime gross is $3.5 billion.
And Eddie's still funny. The donkey in Shrek is one of the funniest things going on, man. It's just...
Well, cartoon voice things are totally different.
He's just a funny guy,
man. You can't F up things. Like, even...
He was
like
good in another 48 Hours.
Like, we were talking about Ice Cube and having no more street cred as far as that because of what he did. And it doesn't matter what you do as a cartoon voice. You could still be like...
He still has street cred.
Does he?
He still has street cred. Ice Cube doesn't... Because if you're a fan of Ice Cube... You can always go back to N.W.A.
Yeah.
Because you don't feel like he was a phony dude. What you do now, you feel like he is 40-something years old.
Yeah.
Eventually, you do have to go through some kind of metamorphosis.
Yeah, but he totally went like white man.
Like it's he went that from white here, money.
He went
people,
from the guys he hated.
People love
singing about the guys
white
he hated
money.
Came that guy.
And then if you don't have any black money, I saw the biography of Mr. T.,
wow.
Once white people got done with
then,
Mr. T,
then I got a mohawk.
They threw him in the dumpster, him and his goal. They just were done with
you
him.
You know what?
Because he went after white money. He didn't go after, like, it just wasn't like a niche where he goes, this money and these people, if I stay loyal to these people forever, then it's like Quentin Tarantino.
Mm-hmm.
He stayed... this kind of boutique dude.
Yeah.
He never really left and tried to be a Steven Spielberg guy.
Right.
He was this guy,
indie guy still.
And he keeps staying that guy.
Who else has gone for black dollars though? You're saying like all right, the Madea movies do, but who else?
Ice Cube did at first.
Well, Boys
Friday
in the Hood.
And
just, oh, yeah.
Boys
yeah,
in the
yeah,
Hood.
Yeah.
And I mean, that was just, that was a
kid
specific,
play.
Kid and play. They probably got millions from those goofy movies, but it was yeah, like, what I'm saying, white dollars, I don't mean white people, doll. I mean family, yeah, like the white that, that's, it's not, it's a, it's not just a color, it's a, it's an idea.
Yeah, I know
and,
what you
and,
mean.
And it's like, the, just to make white people comfortable, it's like some of those movies, there's some white people who are not white, who want to see gangster stuff, who want to see these things, but it's, everybody go, look, Rock just decided, I'm gonna make the game plan. He went from promising in terms of his first movie thing, which he was playing as warrior. But it's
yeah, Scorpion King.
When he was in the Mummy, that's the Scorpion King that he did from when he was in the Mummy
mm-hmm,
to the one where he actually made the Scorpion King was the difference between Conan the Barbarian and Conan the Destroyer.
Mm-hmm.
If you watch Conan the Barbarian, it was gangster. That was a bad movie, dark, evil, nasty movie. Conan the Destroyer was Grace Jones and yeah, yeah, Will Chamberlain and a lot of skipping and a lot of love.
Yeah, you're
and,
right.
And I'm
yeah,
sure
yeah,
Duck was in it too.
You know,
Duck has to be in it for it to be. And that's what I'm saying. Rock should be sick. He should kill somebody in a movie.
But you know what yeah, you know what Rock did, or you know, what Ice Cube did that exemplifies how cheesy he's become, unfortunately, with the Rock's not doing at least. The Rock at least went 100% in that direction. He's like, I'm going to be the kid's guy. Ice Cube puts out Are We There Yet? And then still puts out a record talking about I'm gangster, I'm hard. And it's the two things
well,
together.
The thing
they clash so hard.
Ludacris was on
his
show.
Look at the movie and go, there's no, come
but
on, man.
Some
really?
People, I've never met Ice Cube, but Ludacris, when he was on the show,
yeah,
he was like, I am the he created the character rapper of Ludacris and the actor Chris Atkins, or whatever his name is, and the rapper
Bridges.
Ludacris, Chris Bridges, and then the rapper. It's like they create these. This is the thing. As you, the longer you're in show business, and again the Mr. T thing, they said that Mr. T didn't continue because he wouldn't play that game. He made a zillion dollars off the back of himself,
yeah,
just like and he had one guy hook him up, Sylvester Stallone. He had him cuff him. Said, "Man, make you Clubber Lang." He did that. He made $1 billion off of himself.
Yeah,
and then after he went down and he had to kind of depend on Hollywood to keep him afloat, they go, oh, no, you didn't kiss our ass at that meeting. You didn't eat sushi with us. Yeah, no. You
Come
got
on.
To go. You
I
got
told,
to go.
I told the kids to stay in school.
So when I'm saying black dollars, I don't mean black dollars, Jimmy. I mean just rated R to NC-17 dollars. I'll take that.
Yeah.
I'll take NC-17. Why do I have to always have PG-13 in my life?
When I know, well, they do that. It's for the money.
For
right.
the money.
For the money. When you talk about Ice Cube, though, it is true. He tries to portray himself as still being hard. And the thing is, like,
yeah.
You talk about Ludacris saying he invented this character. I never thought Ice Cube was putting on a character in N.W.A. That was like,
no.
You were scared at the thought of going to South Central
Dude,
listening to that
when
stuff.
When I first heard Straight Outta Compton,
oh my God.
I remember where I was. I remember, I said, who are the, I thought these were people from another planet.
Yes.
I was in Boston, and I said, you're straight out of where?
Yeah, right.
These guys are horrifying.
Patrice.
It was the scariest crap I ever heard.